I was about to do an exhibition at the University of Oklahoma, and the concept wasn't going to work out. And my collaborator, an engineering professor and mathematician at Midwestern, we came up with this idea to talk about things that polarized our world, polarized our country, and what are possible solutions, and how can we take those solutions and really work through them to fix some of the problems that we're dealing with today. As you walk into the gallery space, right now you'll see words that are on the left, that are painted on the walls, and the words on the left are things the students have come up with that are polarizing, things that pull us apart, things that are problems with society. And on the right, there are solutions. There are things that the students think that can, ways that we can fix some of these polarizing issues. It's completely student-driven, and so whatever the students are writing is what stays on the wall. We don't edit. I'm here to facilitate this discussion.
We are doing these big clay balls that are hollow inside, and sometimes we're just using a hemisphere, a half a ball, and these are going to be put on the floor representing some of the things that pull us apart, also representing some of the things that pull us back together. This is dealing with ideas and representing ideas not only with words, but eventually we're going to have a sculpture on the floor that will represent how we can connect despite these very different views we might hold really close.
I must say here, the thoughtfulness and the honesty that's happened in the gallery in the last 2 days has far exceeded my expectation and what I've experienced the last two times I've done this. Your students are very thoughtful. It's obvious that they still have different worldviews. There's still people over here and there's still people over there, but for whatever reason, the conversations that are happening are pretty thoughtful. So it's been good. Best case scenario is that they're talking about what it is they're writing. And whether it's them having the discussion with me sitting around on the floor or the discussion that's happening as they are walking around the gallery, the conversations are happening. And what would be great is if long after we're gone, when the gallery is still up, if professors would continue to bring their students in and have those conversations.